Are you looking for a highly customizable form builder that you can design a really nice looking form? Well, there's a deal that's going on right now that's called Snakeet, and it does exactly that. It's kind of a mix of a form builder, image designer, and a landing page builder. So all of that mixed into one. So what I like about it, and I think that Snakeet stands out, is that it's highly customizable because you have that image designer where you can move modules, you can move the look of it, instead of having that plain design where you have to work with what you have. Some type of form builders just have blocks that you can just move around and put a background and that's it. Not with this one. You can do a lot of customization with it and make it look really nice and flashy. So let's go check this out on my desktop right now. What's up everyone? My name is George and this is SaaS Master. The deal that I'm talking about, it's called Snakeet. It's in a lifetime deal right now and it starts off at $59 for the lifetime deal. If you guys wanna check it out, that link will be provided in the description. Now, let me show you what those deal terms gets you with the $59 deal. Let me go down here and there we go. So the $59 plan gets you all the features above, which are these right here. So you get access to unlimited pages per story, unlimited quizzes, surveys, and forms, etc. All of that. And you are tied to the croissant plan updates, okay? So you get 5,000 responses per month. So these renew every single month in the lifetime deal. 2 gigabytes file upload. You can clean those files if it reaches that limit. 2 members, 1 workspace, and it's white label. So you can add your own logos and that kind of stuff. Now, if you need more responses per month and you need custom shared URL, you would need to jump into license tier 2. What is the custom shared URL? Well, that means you can add your own custom domain. So when you share the link to a form or a page, well, it doesn't have that Snakeet link. It has your own domain's link. Now you can kind of do a workaround with this using a link shortener because you would use the link shortener with your own domain and kind of mask that link. That's a workaround, okay? But if you need more responses, more upload and more members, you would need to jump into license tier 2, 3, etc. You can go to license tier 4 and you get way more limits. You get unlimited for everything. So if you like this deal and you think it's well worth it, I do recommend jumping into license tier 4 because you have unlimited responses and you're not limited to that. Even with file uploads, everything is just unlimited with that. And you get unlimited story custom domain CNAME, okay? So that's for the deal terms. Like I mentioned before, that link will be provided in the description. Do subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Okay, let me go into my dashboard. This is my Snakeet dashboard. And I'm gonna show you really quickly how flexible this is. And there's kind of a little learning curve to actually get started with this. Let me start off with a new story. And we have 3 options. We have the classic, which is just the elements and all of that, kind of use this for landing pages. The quiz, if you want to ask questions, and the survey, if you plan to, again, ask questions, but in a survey mode. Let's choose survey, and we'll call this survey for video. Oops. Survey, and we have 2 language options, English and French. I hope they add Spanish, but again, your needs might be different and you might need different languages, but right now it's only English and French. Let's go next, and we're gonna be presented with templates. This is one of their weak points. I think that templates are really limited, and the templates that I see commonly here are kind of playful, cartoonish, and they're not like professional, right? You can build your own again, but I wish there was already templates that are professional and way more templates. Now there's only 2 in this category. Let me go back again and I'll choose quiz because there's more on those. So I'll just change this to quiz so we keep track. Let's go next and you can see there's more elements here. So a little bit more professional, but again, I wish they had way more templates. I am just going to choose one of these. I'll go with this one. I can go ahead and preview it before I choose it. And I'll go next. They have categories on the top, but again, there's not too many templates to even consider like filtering by categories. Okay, so this is loading the builder, okay? This is the Snakeet builder. And like I mentioned before, there's a little learning curve, but once you see this video, you'll understand that it's pretty easy. So on the left, we have the pages. Here we go. You can select it and you'll start editing these once you've selected. And once we click on these elements, we have the options on the right. So if I click on this text, we have the text editor right there. Now, if I want to add elements, they are right here. So in between the canvas and the options. So these are the elements that we have. I can change the background. I can add text, title, subtitle, paragraph. I can add an image, video, shape, tag, location, calendar. Location is tied to Google Calendar. Okay, so as for that, next thing that you want to know is the layers. So here are the layers that we have. These are the layers that we have on the right. So if I click on this little bar, well, I have selected the layer and I can move this around. Now, like I mentioned before, this is what makes, for me, stand out Snakeet, the highly customization of the form. So I can click on the elements, I can drag them around. I'm not tied to blocks, okay? Most form editors are tied to blocks and you can only work what you have there and change the background. That's it. You can't add elements to this. So if I want to add a shape here, I'll just select it and have a bunch of shapes that I have available here. I can search around or I can add something like this. And I don't know, I can do like there, give it a little different look to it. And it makes me do that customization. And each element that I select, I have the options on the far right. So I have the shape editor for this. I have the select the file, I can set settings and animation. So I can add animations to this. I have the alignments, position, size, rotation, opacity, color. I can flip it around. I can just border. I want to add a border to this and it's transparent, so I'll red. Okay, just going crazy here just to show you what you can do, okay? So there's that little border there. I can add some animation to this. So I can add some bouncing. See how that bounced? Swing, back and right. Let me put it in the middle, okay? Fade in. Do that, backflip, etc. All right, I can just click delete and it's gone. That's what I like about it. It's moving around elements that help me do all of this to make it highly customizable. Now, if I click on the start button, we have these options, okay? So I have the title for it, the rounded button, so I can round it off or I can keep it kind of like squared with rounded corners. Add emojis on click. So when I click on it, it's gonna like show little emojis on it. Now I have the option to turn that off if I like. Let me show you really quickly right here. Let me test it. Here's just a demo test. I'm going to click start and you're gonna see the emojis pop up. Boop. See that there? It adds that little effect, things that you wouldn't do with a normal form editor, okay? Form builder, okay? And we have other options for the font, size, text color, etc., alignment, the borders, and all of that. I can go ahead and reset that if I like. Now, what's gonna happen? Redirect to, I can select here, where I want it to go to. In this case, obviously the next page, but I could do something different. Do I want to display the start button or not? I'll cancel that because it's gonna jump this section. Now, if I want to edit the next page, I'll go right here. And in this case, we have a little element right here that is the questions, okay? So in this case, this is where we come in into the form builder, okay? So in this case, I can change the answer type. So right now we have buttons for choosing, okay, questions. But if I want to change this element or add an element, I'll just click change answer type. And we have these options available here. So for example, it could be buttons, choice image, URL, file upload, file download, text, email, phone, number, drop down, all the normal ones that you would have on form builder. Yes, no, good, bad, and you get options of how these would look, okay? Emotions, bad, average, etc. Okay, if I wanted to switch it, I can do so right there. I'll keep it as it is right now. And we have the options for this element right here. So I could change the type, is it text, is it image and text? Is it variable, assign a variable to this? So if I wanna assign a variable to use this later on. So for example, if I'm asking for the name in one of these elements for text, I can make that variable and use it in another block after that, okay? So in this case, both are correct answers and I can say that false could be the wrong answer. Let me turn that off. You can have two right ones or bad ones. This little green bar and an X mark, you won't see them on the test on the end results, okay? This is just for me, so I can see this, that what's going on, okay? I can add another choice or button if I like, okay? So that's for the editor. I'm gonna go next. This one is an image one. So you can see its image displays here and I can edit these images by clicking on it. If I want to edit the image, I can choose from my library. I can use a link to put one inside of there. I can use pixels, Giphy sticker, and pixel base. So if I want to change that, I can do so by doing it that way. Another type of element is this one right here. So again, I'll choose it. And here's the elements, fields required. This kind of like at the end, you take that survey and at the end, we're asking for the name and email. That's what this is all about. So in this case, we have the name element, email, and phone. I can add more fields to this and customize an error message if I like. I have the customization for all the fields and make it ask for consent. Okay, so these are the consents for it, for GDPR, for example. And we have a little red mark here, which we can view here on the top. If I hover over this one error, it's saying GDPR consent text is not fully customized. Please remove all variables. Okay, so these are the variables that this element has. That's why I'm getting this error. Now, if you're getting this, it's because you don't have other elements tied to it. So for example, I don't have a variable before this that's asking for the address, the website, and over here, the client name. But if I get rid of all of this, provided by example, turns to blue because now it's okay. There's no variables to it. But obviously, work with it and leave it as you would like, okay? So that's for the editor. I mean, it's kind of a little weird at the beginning because you don't know what's going on, but like I said, once you watch this video, you're gonna understand it. If you wanna change template, you have the option here. There we go, you can select it. If I wanna add a page in between, I'll click the little plus button, form page, the name, the page settings. There we go, you can do some fade-ins, some animations, and etc. Next thing we have is the setup on the top. So for example, we can change the language after this. Obviously, I don't want to. If I want to add some users, user configuration, notification configuration, the versions of this, if you want to revert to a publish, just in case you mess something up, the display progress bar. So if you want, there's like those little tabs, as you would see them in stories, like Facebook stories, Instagram stories, there's little tabs on the top. You can remove that. You can display the branding. We have the connect options. You can integrate with different things. Like I mentioned before, it's also working like a page builder. So obviously you get options like Google Analytics, Tag Manager, Pixel, and you can integrate with other ones like Google Sheets, Google Drive, Gmail, Slack, etc. But for me, everything is done with webhook. With webhooks, you could probably connect with anything. You have the option for Zapier and Pally Connect. Next thing we have is the share option. I can assign variables, the share story URL, share story email. You also have share with widget that's available if you want to embed this on your site and have that little like icon in it. So it's pretty useful. Obviously you wouldn't use this. You would change your own icon. You can display on the left or right, the icon display, full screen opening. If you wanted to take over the full screen, delay before it automatically opens, and you get the options for the delays. Domain whitelist. So wherever you're going to embed this, you need to whitelist the domain, because if someone just grabs this code and puts it on their site, it's going to display it. But if you whitelist it, it's only going to work on the site that you have it embed. And you can also have the option for embed the widget and more widget commands. You can share with iframe. Also, you have the embed code or share the QR code, which is pretty useful when you are on the exposition. So you're in an expo and you have a stand there. Well, you have a QR code, so you want people to scan it and they can go into these little pages or take a survey, give them a price for it or whatever, a discount, whatever you would like to do with it. And there's also the analytics. Let me show you one of the analytics from the one I already tested. I'll go ahead and publish this one now. There we go, it's published. Let's go into my general stories. There's the survey views. One finished. Okay, this one, I was playing with this one, so I'll click on it. Here we go. Let's go into analyze. Here we go. And these are the analytics that we're going to get. So total users one, because that's the test that I was just playing around with, the average score, testing with the results, and you get the unique users per page and new page. You can filter these out. You can filter also by desktop, mobile, tablet. My test was done on desktop, so we're gonna get the results there. And you can view detailed data here. So you can filter these out also. So if you want to view all of these, just filter as you would like to see the results. But there you go. That is the Snakeet deal. Like I mentioned before, what makes it stand out from other phone builders is the highly customization of the look, the animation, and the possibility to also use it as a landing page. Now, if you ask my personal opinion, if you're looking for a serious form builder, I would recommend something else. But if you're looking for a simple form builder that you can highly customize, then this would be a good deal for you. But there you go, that's a Snakeet deal. If you guys want to grab it, that link will be provided in the description, which helps me out with a small commission, and it's not going to cost you a single cent more than what it already says there. Well, I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you on my next videos.